as you can probably tell from the various things laid out in front of me today, we are going to be doing some swatching, and specifically we are going to be swatching my Promarkers, which I've been collecting and using for probably about 15 years now, maybe slightly longer, I'm not too sure, but it's been a little while since I last did some swatching, and I have here the official swatch sheet. Every time I go in, I'll be grabbed. I always keep my eyes peeled for any new This is in fact a colour unique to Promarker, according to that little circle on the sheet, because they do both Promarkers with these thin tips, and they also do brush markers as well with slightly more broader flexible tips to cover larger surface areas. So I have a combination of those two different types. But I've always been more of a traditional artist than a digital artist. I've got a third degree here, and it is in fact limited edition, so good job. It does kind of feel a little Just ended up living in the art department. always enjoy doing art. It's lime green there, and it's another brush marker. I do find myself wondering, since I don't have lime zest, as you can see I have lime green, but I do find myself wondering what's the difference between the two. I guess I'll just have to buy the second one and find out. But lime green is quite satisfying. Enjoyed with art, you know, bringing something to life that's existing in your head and sketching it out on the page, trying to get as close as you can to the image that is in your head. Meadow green, where is that? There it is. It's always a bit of a battle with yourself, because so often what you see in your head isn't quite what you end up with as the finished product on the page, and sometimes that can be a little bit disheartening, because you feel like what you've imagined is so much better than the final product. But what you have to remember is, even though you can see satisfying shade of yellow, that one. Doesn't want to go back in. There we are. Oh, now we have yellow. This is the most yellow yellow you can possibly get. Another cheerful colour that I think is very difficult to dislike overall. But I don't have too many shades of orange, actually. This one is very orange. Indeed, it is bright orange, which is just underneath. a shade of brown than it is a shade of red. There we go. This now is berry red. You can tell this is one of the ones I've had for a while. Satisfying about swatching. Slowly seeing it all, filling the page. There we go. And it's also, of course, very useful to see what you don't yet have. For me, that seems to be quite. Used to have a pink bedroom salmony pink shades and skin tones as well, because they often get duplicated in sets. And you can, of course, get just skin tone shade sets as well. This is soft peach, right next door. It's quite useful, I have to say, having a lot of different shades of brown. You never know when you might need a few different varieties. Got a couple of flex markers there, which are not pro markers, so we're not going to swatch them. But we will swatch cinnamon. Sorry. is it somewhere else? See, now that's just cheating. It's over in oranges. You'd think with a name like Saddle Brown, you would in fact put it in the browns. But no. Windsor and Newton like to keep us on our toes. This is now the very final brown, and it's spice, which is not there. It's another cheat. It's over in oranges. So according to Windsor and Newton, I have more oranges than I thought I did. Thank you. always forget what I have in this set. It's a very useful one because it has so many different colour groups in it. Really does cover a sort of base range of pretty much everything apart from skin tones, which, as you saw, I already have quite a lot of. Final orange of the set. Okay. Washed out denim right there. Oh, now is this gonna be a green? Turquoise. It's a blue.